Today, she's a typical American housewife. The woman next door. But when she was a teenager, Annette Funicello was a television star.
Annette!
A recording star.
Polka!
And a movie star.
Put down beans and cross out cake. Let me see. Oh, dear me. What a job to undertake. Milk plus bread. Oh, my head.
Well, first of all, if I had never gotten into show business, I would be an aging ballerina right now. I mean, you know, how long can that go on? Let's face it. But because of those ears and Walt Disney, things, wonderful things happened. It was like living at Disneyland all the time, like being in Fantasyland.
The career of Annette Funicello, the girl next door who became an American legend, in this chapter of the Disney Family Album. Annette's mother, Virginia Funicello, preserved the memories of her daughter's life in the limelight in a family scrapbook.
That's Some Enchanted Evening, and I think right. This is when Mr. Disney mm-hmm. was sitting in my audience.
Yeah, she was a swan queen in Swan Lake.
Yeah, who ever dreamed? I was a dancer, and at the end of every school year, they put on a recital, the teacher does, and unannounced, Walt Disney was in the audience because he had been looking for Mouseketeer material at the time. And of course, nobody knew this. I didn't know he was out there, but he saw me dance. I had the lead in Swan Lake, and next day called my dancing school teacher. He said, I'd like to see the little dark-haired girl. Could you bring her into the studio? So that's how it all started. There were 24 Mouseketeers, and 23 had been chosen, and I was the last one.
The Mouseketeers performed in public for the first time at the opening of Disneyland on July 17, 1955. Soon, Annette, Cubby, Darlene, and the rest would be household names.
A lot of the popularity of the show was because he found kids that were like the kids next door. Nobody was so professional. Nobody was so polished. We became friends with the audience, you know, and the kids could say, hey, I think I could sing as well as so-and-so, or I think I could do that dance. I learned that in school. And I think we were just friends, and we were on their level. We just didn't try to be pretentious or better than anybody.
We're the Mouseketeers. We want to say hello and give three cheers for all of you who see us every day. You're okay, so welcome to our mountain club. And by the way, while you're here, you're all the guests of the Merry Mouseketeers. We'd like to introduce ourselves to you. So proudly put on your Mouseketeers. It's time to meet the Mouseketeers.
Roll call.
Cheryl.
Bobby. Jimmy!
My dear, dear friend Jimmy Dodd.
Yeah, we loved him so much.
He taught me how to play the ukulele, which was called the mouse guitar. It was in the shape of a mouse. Special, special man.
Hi, Mouseketeers. Today we have some words to grow by, and I'm going to call on Annette to give them to you. Annette? Hi, Annie.
Hi, Jimmy.
All ready?
Ready.
Okay.
Beauty is as beauty does. That's what wise men say. Now, if you would be beautiful, do this every day. If you're as raise you to the sky.
I was one of the most timid individuals. I had no confidence whatsoever. I mean, my mother said the doorbell used to ring and I used to run and hide. I thought, I just won't be able to do this. I'm scared to death, and there's millions of people that I'm looking at in this little lens. But I did, and it wasn't as bad as I thought.
Be sure to think you're beautiful and praise you to the sky.
Oh, thanks, Annette. Wonderful words to grow by.
The fan mail started pouring in, but of course we were never told because some Mouseketeers got more than others. I remember one day Mr. Disney came up to me and he said, "Wow, you must have a lot of Italian relatives back east watching this show." And I said, "What do you mean?" And he said, "The fan mail and the gifts coming in for you, young lady, are just phenomenal." That was my first clue that I was sort of singled out.
In addition to her popularity with audiences, Annette was also the apple of Walt Disney's eye.
Just to point out how really special he was to me, I had always gone by the one name, you know, on my sweatshirt. So when I stayed under contract, I wanted to change my name because nobody could pronounce Funicello. And we didn't even say Funicello then. My mom and dad sort of Americanized it and pronounced it Funicello. So I went to Mr. Disney one day and I said, "Please, please, could I change my name? I would love to be Annette Turner." And he said, "Annette Turner?" He said, "Aren't you proud of your Italian heritage?" And I said, "Yeah, I'm very proud of it, but nobody can pronounce my last name." And he said, "First of all, young lady, you are mispronouncing it. It is not Funicello, it's Funicello. It's a beautiful Italian name. Once people learn how to pronounce it, they won't forget it." And I said, "Yes, sir, thank you." And he was right.
For 3 years, the Mouseketeers filmed 5 days a week and worked weekends at Disneyland.
Believe it or not, we all got along. There were 24 of us. And we became like brothers and sisters, which meant your ordinary little squabbles, little arguments. But all brothers and sisters do that, you know? We had our little crushes on each other. My big crush was Lonnie.
It was an especially sad day in 1958 when their series came to an end. None of them knew if this meant the end of their careers.
I've never cried so hard in my life. And just having to go to each member of the crew to say goodbye, you know, everybody was uncle, and saying goodbye to my buddies, the Mouseketeers. Of course, we promised that we would all stay in touch, and we have. We truly have. We have reunion parties all the time. And, it was a sad day to see something so beautiful come to an end.
Why? Because we like you.
M-O-U.
As it turned out, Annette was the only Mouseketeer who remained under contract at Disney. The girl next door was a star, and the studio knew it. As part of the Mouseketeer series, Spin and Marty, like most American boys, loved her.
Here, Annette.
Thank you, but how am I going to eat all this?
Don't worry, I'll help you.
Well, the first thing she did by herself was the Annette series. Do you know about the Annette series? I loved her in that. She played a poor farm girl who was so backward with the kids in school, she went to live with a rich aunt.
Hi, Steve. Who's your country cousin? Don't tell me she's a kissing cousin.
Oh, don't be silly. I never saw her before.
So she had to get up and sing.
Oh, that was on the hayride.
Well,
where they had me sing How Will I Know My Love, and everybody laughed at me.
Yeah, and she, no, you got up and sang. Do you remember that?
How will I know my love? How will I know my darling? Whipper will give me a sign. How will I know he's mine? How will I know my love? When he walks through the pine woods, mockingbird tell me for true. Help me to find him, do.
It's very kind of a dumb song. All the kids loved it. It sold 200,000 copies. She never sang in her life.
No.
I didn't even know she could carry a tune. That was my favorite. I loved it.
Polka!
The girl next door had the voice next door.
Camouflaged. I was the first one to start the double voice and the tremendous echo chambers. I would sing the song the first time, and then you listen in the earphones, and you sing it exactly the same over your original voice. And that sort of became an Annette sound, and then it was done frequently after that. But as long as I had those echo chambers behind me, I felt very confident.
We really raised the ruckus on the campus, all right.
Many of Annette's top singles was written by Richard and Robert Sherman, who wrote some of Disney's most popular music.
She was one of the number one artists in the country. I mean, everyone bought her records, played her records. We had so many songs on the charts with her simultaneously.
She was the Cyndi Lauper of her day.
Well, we started a series of albums. The first was Hawaiianette. And the second one was Italianette, and then we came out with Dancinette, and somebody said, why don't you do a bayonet or a bathinet? And, you know, we got kind of crazy with the whole thing. But it was fun, and they worked. You know, some good songs came out of those albums, too.
These senoritas and caballeros wearing denim and capris.
Tell you another one. One time we had to make a disc for a television. You know, you put a quarter in those days and you see, similar to what they do today, only on a smaller
scale.
Videos.
Yeah.
And what was the name of that song? You come home from a date.
Last night I was the rock and roll waltz, wasn't it?
So they asked Joe and I to be the mom and dad, and she's coming up the stairs with her shoes very quietly because it's real late. I've danced with Joe for years and years. We're good dancers.
Excellent dancers.
I just couldn't do it. He was doing fine. Oh, after 100 takes, she cracked me up. She'd see me with this terrible look on my face. And she'd laugh. We took 100 takes on it.
My dad couldn't even maneuver her on the dance floor. She was like this, like a robot. So scared, she froze. And I was laughing.
One night I was late. Came home from a date. Slipped out of my shoes at the door. Then from the front room, I heard a jump tune. I looked in, and here's what I saw. There in the night was a wonderful scene. Mom was dancing with Dad to my record machine.
So, you know, after each song kind of made the charts, made some noise, I thought, how much longer can this go on? I don't sing. You know, enough is enough. And it was crazy. My mom and I would be gone sometimes 7 weeks at a time of one-nighters. But I got the top 10 songs.
It's old, but it's new. I love the rock and
you're in a lot of these pictures.
Oh, Zorro. Oh, she was so in love with Zorro. Look, the love of my life.
Yeah.
Too bad I was so ugly. He never paid any attention to her. He was in love with her teacher. And for my 16th birthday, Walt Disney knew that I was crazy in love with Guy Williams, who was Zorro. And came to me one day with a script, and he said, how would you like to appear in a Zorro? And I said, you're kidding me? And he said, well, now that you're all grown up, here's your script. And I got to sing Jimmy Dodd's song, Lonely Guitar, in the Zorro.
Lonely guitar, now our song is a sad song. Longing we are for someone to adore.
Oh, Diego.
No, no, please. Continue. It's lovely.
I was merely passing the time.
I would like to ask you something. Do you still want to find him, huh?
He's my father, isn't he? Whatever he does in California, does that change the kind of man he really is?
And it was such a thrill for me that even Mr. Disney would think of such a wonderful birthday present. And they had a big surprise party for me when the show was finished taping. And it was one of the nicest experiences of my life.
Annette literally grew up at the Disney studio. It was a fantasy world, but one in which she shared the predicaments of every other girl her age. For instance, whether or not to change the color of her hair.
While I was still a Mouseketeer, I used to see these pretty little blonde or red-haired girls come to the studio to sort of go in and out, and I would say, what is she here for? Well, she's being auditioned for Babes in Toyland. And this went on for, like, maybe 2 years, and all of a sudden, one day, Mr. Disney came to me again, and he said, come with me to the hairdressing department. We want to see how you would look as a redhead. And I said, what? So they put a red wig on me, and he said, there's our Mary Quite Contrary.
Annette, I want you to meet our guests.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to our party.
In Babes in Toyland, Annette and Tommy Sands play the romantic leads of Mary Quite Contrary and Tom the Piper's Son. And like any two kids in love, they sing together and they dance together.
Toyland was Annette's first feature film and opened new worlds on which her star could shine.
Merlin Jones, the campus kook, but my heart's whirling. I'm the girl in love with Merlin Jones.
Annette also sang the title song and starred in The Misadventures of Merlin Jones.
Kiss me. What?
No, I mean it. Kiss me.
Not here in the science building.
What better place for scientific experiment? Jenny, I want to see what kind of a brainwave reaction I have when you kiss me. Besides, there's nobody around.
Well, if it's part of a scientific experiment, I suppose it's all right.
Mm. Wow, look at that. Now, that is what I call a kiss.
Interesting. Can we go now?
Uh-uh. It's your turn now.
Me?
Mm-hmm. You put this on, and now I kiss you.
You sure this comes under the heading of science?
Absolutely, yeah.
All right.
I played the girl next door, as I usually do. You know, there was always the glamorous one that Tommy Kirk fell for, and of course I was crazy about Tommy Kirk in the movie, but I was the girl next door, and he ignored me when this little French number came along. I always play the girl next door. You know, never get the guy. Always the nice girl next door.
This one here, honey.
Oh, that was the Golden Horseshoe.
Yeah.
Remember, I went up on stage as a school marm, and
yeah,
I ripped off the cape.
It came out like that.
Yeah.
Proof that the Mouseketeer had grown up, Walt Disney cast her as a dance hall entertainer in a television special at Disneyland's Golden Horseshoe Review.
Mr. Piano Man, please tickle those ivory keys. No one can noodle the way that you doodle those rickety-ticky melodies.
As part of her grown-up status, Annette also sang with the Beach Boys for the title sequence of a new Disney film.
Well, I don't care what the whole world thinks.
She loves the monkey's uncle.
Call us a couple of missing links.
She loves the monkey's uncle.
Love all his monkey shines. Every day is Valentine's. I love the monkey's uncle and the monkey's uncle's ate for me.
In 1963, Annette left Disney and headed for the beach, where she made a series of movies that all seemed to have the same plot.
A wonderful summer at the beach. Nobody ever had jobs. No one ever asked where the parents were. It was just good, clean fun. Mr. Disney had full script approval of everything that I did. And he read the first script, which was Beach Party, which I thought was the best one of them. And there again, he came to me one day and said, I'd like to ask a favor of you, Annette. He said, I know that you're on the beach and all the girls will be bikini clad, but you have an image to uphold, and I would request of you not to wear a bikini. Would you please wear a one piece? And I said, you got it. And to this day, that is always talked about. It's brought out. Annette never exposed the navel because Walt Disney asked her not to. You know, and I respected him so much, and I felt that he was right, and he was.
In 1965, Annette traded in stardom for motherhood when the first of her three children was born.
Mr. Disney was so wonderful to me when I had my firstborn. He sent over the characters. Mickey and Minnie and Donald came into my room. Can you imagine when the doctors and nurses saw Mickey and Minnie walk down the hall into my room? It's just indescribable.
For Annette, three children easily took the place of millions of fans. But for some of those fans, the flame still burns bright. This Disney memorabilia shop in Los Angeles is run by Annette fan Bob Molinari and his Annette fan dog.
And on our block, we had run home from school to watch the club, and we'd have little recitals in the garage. Watch every day, never missed. It was one of those things that made growing up a lot of fun.
At this new wave radio station in Los Angeles, Annette's music is still in demand thanks to disc jockey Rodney Bingenheimer.
Well, her music is the best, I say. In fact, I play her on my radio show on KROQ. In fact, that's how the whole thing started. I started playing cuts from her earlier albums, like Swinging and Surfing, you know, from the Beach Party album, and then Jamaica Ska off of the Bikini Beach album. And then I started playing like Indian Giver by Annette, which is kind of an Adam and the Ants sound. And I got tons of phone calls, requests off the hook, you wouldn't believe.
Hello, more Annette? Uh-huh, yeah. More Annette, okay. More Annette, right, more Annette. Put on another Annette.
She's stunned by it, and I guess she's getting back into music, you know. And she goes out shopping or to dinner. People come up to her and go, oh, we hear you on Rodney's show all the time.
Romano and Roll, I'm KROQ with Annette Funicello.
Yeah.
Recently, she starred in the Disney Channel movie, Lots of Luck.
Slow down, Mom, slow down.
No, faster, Mom, faster.
Slow down faster.
Mom, I can't be late. Kevin paces my homeroom at exactly 8:06. Give me a break.
I was absolutely playing myself. I mean, here I was, the mother of three children, driving carpools, cooking dinners, everything always breaking down at one time. I mean, it really and truly was me.
Her singing career has found new life in a recently released country and western album.
When I got to Nashville and my first day to arrive at the recording studio, I opened that heavy door that lets you in, and my heart was just beating so fast. I was so timid and so frightened of the whole thing, and I opened that door, and there were the musicians, and they sang M-I-C-K-E-Y. Now, what more of a welcome could you ask for than that?
When the Mouseketeers reunite as they did for their 25th anniversary in 1980, it's a national television event.
I guess some people felt those old bones wouldn't move like they used to. And do you know, each one of us remembered every lyric to every song, remembered every dance routine, and we were pretty proud of ourselves. I mean, those old bones still could move again. These little babies right here. Yes, I owe everything to these ears. I truly do.
Who's the little lady who's as dainty as a dream? Who's the one you can't forget? I'll give you just three guesses. Annette, Annette, Annette. When she dances on her toes, she dances in your heart with her pretty pirouette. Each little move expresses Annette, Annette, Annette. Mais oui, she's so magnifique, and her father's pride and mother's joy. There will come a day they'll give Annette away to the world's luckiest boy. Ask the birds and ask the bees and ask the stars above who's their favorite swifrenette. You know each one confesses Annette, Annette, Annette.